Welcome to this recital. It's a very great pleasure to be performing for you today on this instrument, which I had the great honour to be involved with as advisor. It's a fabulous new machine by Skrabl, and it really is designed around some of the French symphonic organ ideas. And I've prepared a programme today which I hope you'll enjoy, designed to show off as many of the colours and also the sheer glorious power of this instrument. The great organist Jean Langlais was almost blind from birth and became blind at a very early age. He was organist of Saint Clotilde and was renowned as a composer, performer and teacher. And I'm going to play for you now his Incantation pour un jour saint, which is specifically written for the Easter Vigil. And in it you will hear a number of Gregorian themes, most notably at the beginning where you will hear the Light of Christ, which is sung by the priest in that service. He sings it three times, rising on each occasion, and you'll hear that at the opening and in several other points during this very exciting piece of music. Alongside the Gregorian chants, you also have the great, exciting Toccata figuration, and it makes a real and epic journey from darkness to light.
Thank you.
Naji Hakim was Messiaen's successor at La Trinité, having spent time at Sacré-Cœur prior to that. He was also renowned very much as a teacher, and I was fortunate to study with him in Paris on a number of occasions. I'm going to play his little suite, Mariales, which are five very short movements, all quiet and reflective in nature, and all based on Marian Gregorian chants. There's moments of sheer beauty, particularly in the Antienne, modelled on the Sabra Regina, and also really some wonderfully sort of almost comic moments, some light-hearted moments, and an opportunity to hear some of the wonderful and sometimes quite rustic colours of the organ.
Thank you.
There is a very strong tradition of basing organ pieces around existing hymn tunes, and you're going to hear four modern examples of this now. Malcolm Archer's Toccata on All for Jesus is an exciting and thrilling piece in which the tune is heard throughout and not heavily disguised. You'll hear it first of all at the very opening, and it's then decorated in the middle and recurs finally with an opportunity to highlight the fabulous enchaînement trumpets of this organ. Richard Jeffrey Gray is director of music of Clifton Cathedral and a well-renowned composer in his own right, having written the music for The Last Flight of the Concorde, amongst many other things. This is a very beautiful meditation upon the theme Pange Lingua, which you'll hear at the opening upon the clarinet stop. It builds to a huge climax in the middle before fading away into silence. The hymn tune Hyfrydol is probably my favourite hymn tune of all, and I think one of the greatest tunes to have come out of the hymn writing factories of that country. This is a toccata and fanfare based upon that melody, which you'll hear at the start in fragments, and the piece builds up, varying it into the minor key until finally on the last few pages it explodes into a great harmonization of the tune, given, if you like, in full view, finally building to absolute full organ. Sarah MacDonald is Director of Music at Selwyn College, Cambridge, and a great advocate of new music. I'm going to play her beautiful little chorale prelude based on Solothurn, and it very much is modelled on some of the chorale preludes of Bach, having a walking bass accompaniment in the left hand and a decorated tune in the right hand on the cornet.
Thank you.
Cecilia McDowell is one of our foremost composers and had the recent distinction of being the most performed female composer. She is a great writer of music for choir, for organ and instrumental music, and I'm going to play you now her wonderful celebration, which was originally written for Portsmouth University and its graduation ceremonies. It's a very exciting, glittering piece, and I feel the title Celebration could not be more appropriate to this season of Easter.